It's a microphone. It's locked, this one. It's a bit stiff, yeah. You only pliers. There you go.
Strangely not on me.
Yeah, with me.
It's not what I hear. Hello, good evening. My name's Ted Key. I'm going to do two songs, for they are songs. There we go. This first one I wrote, and it was actually on the UCU's website, and it was about workloads for teachers. And I sang it in front of the Radio Humberside when we had a strike day, and we threatened to sing it when we had a meeting at the City Hall, and the principal rang the union rep and said, "You can't do that. You can't do that. Tell him he can't come and sing it at the City Hall. We'll go back into negotiations." So fuck Bob Dylan. I actually did some. Anyway, it's called I've Got an Itchy Arse. No, it's not called that. It's called This Job Is Killing Me. Did I actually say I've got an itchy arse? Or did it? Was it in my head? Okay. I teach the poor and the destitute on social enterprise. I work all day for my meagre pay, and little does it rise. Each night by the light of a low-watt bulb, I tick and cross and scribble faint manuscripts of dubious prose, reconstituted drivel. Me wife, she moans, me bairns, they cry, I hide me sen away, catching up with me marking pile, three trolley loads a day. Oh, principal, why can't you see this job is killing me? Me holidays are long, they say, me working day is short, but they don't see me schemes of work nor end of term reports. For each new course now there must be detailed curricula. The more I do look forward to my ASPDR, which is your annual assessment shit. Me retention rate, it is out of date. I'll improve them when I can. This year I'm here, next year I'm there. Now who knows where I am? Oh, principal, why can't you see this job is killing me? For captains of our industries with spreadsheets at their sides, for managers of percentages, we must prioritise. To train and educate, my friend, is our priority. Each woman and each man will aid economic recovery. But stay your hand if you should think your bonuses to share. It fills me with humility just knowing that you care. Oh, principal, why can't you see this job is fucking killing me? There's a solo there, but obviously I'm not going to. Me students can be challenging, demanding of me time, so the hours in me working week now stretch to 29. There's little time for bairns to grow, to watch them fight and play. Before you know, there's tuition fees and mortgages to pay. Public sector pension schemes are generous and fair, so if I last, I'll sail away from all these woes and cares. Oh, principal, why can't you see this job is killing me? The second one is another song, which has a rather long preamble. It's about... there's a place that was shut now, and there was Antone's Guitars on Beverly Road, and there was the gig shop, which was run by a guy called Lynn. And I went in there one day to pick up a PA for a gig, and we were chatting away. And he says, "You know what the problem is, Ted, these days? There's 1,000 bands for 100 gigs. You know, what he's saying is like all the venues are closing down. You know, and back in the day, there were working men's clubs, because women don't work, you know, working men's clubs, and there were acts on live music every Friday and Saturday night, sometimes Sunday night, and I used to play them, I used to go around and do them, and there was loads of places to play. Now it's all sort of shutting down, and there's only a few gigs left for us poor musicians. I'm sure you feel sorry for me. Anyway, and another funny thing is Rob Phoenix, who you saw earlier, who was really good. I know him. I knew him. I met him on our allotment. Not our allotment. We don't share an allotment. We're not lovers. Please don't jump to that conclusion. But we had separate allotments. I don't know, we may become lovers. He's a very attractive man. We had separate allotments, so we used to chat about stuff. And then I was talking to a guy online who used to be in a band called Dead Fingers Talk. I don't know if anybody remembers them, but a famous old band. He was writing his sort of biography and all these things. He used to go down to London and, you know, record and meet people and go and see bands. And it was around like mid-70s, so he saw the Sex Pistols and the Clash and all that kind of stuff. And so I was saying, God, you know, that's really good. You should make it into a book. And he says, oh, yeah, well, our lead singer's got an allotment as well. I says, what's his name? He says, Rob. I says, fuck me, is it? So it was Rob, and it's a small world. Anyway, I'm sure Rob will agree that there's 1,000 bands for 100 gigs. And inspired by Rob's performance, I'd like to have a little bit of audience participation. So when I say that there's 1,000 bands for 100 gigs, you can hurl it back at me in whatever fashion you feel is appropriate. No, we're not doing all that. This is a song. This is mine. So this is called 100 gigs. Here we go. I played a sheer gold masquerader back in the day when there used to be a lot of little places to play. The old New York and the Welly Club, Spiders and the New Adelphi Club. The Union Par would put on a band or two. You might even get a folk club down at the old zoo. Now the promoters are bent and the venues are rigged. Because there's 1,000 bands for 100 gigs.
There's 1,000 bands for 100 gigs.
Oh, that was awful. That was awful. We'll try it again next time, anyway.
We need a metronome.
Yeah.
All right, then. Let's do it to a beat, then.
Yeah.
Okay. The old-fashioned pubs are closing down. There's a million brand new places in town, and cafe bars where you can eat and drink, noisy clubs where you can't hear yourself think. Every pub's got a giant plasma screen, and every pub opens up for under 18s. You might make enough money for a packet of six. Oh yeah, baby. Because there's 1,000 bands for 100 gigs.
There's 1,000 bands for 100 gigs.
Yeah! I'm getting into this now. Now if you do get a chance to plug and play, there's a queue round the block the very next day. Everybody's got their own websites, but all the bands are shit and their songs are shite. Their rich daddy bought them a brand new Gibson Les Paul, and they can all murder Wonderwall. They even think Oasis made up of their own riffs. Cause there's 1,000 bands for 100 gigs.
There's 1,000 bands for 100 gigs.
This is the dub version. The band's in the van, but the bass player's sick. The drummer got pissed and forgot his sticks. We're heading down south just to play the smoke. Get stopped by the cops because the headlights broke. The KPH is dark and boarded up. The marquee's gone, but there's still the 100 club. The mother black cap is flat and nice posh gigs. Now there's 1,000 bands for 100 gigs.
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 Yeah. Tiki!
Tell the fucking musicians to wreck the fucking stage. Okay, brilliant. Ted K, fantastic. Next up, from across the pond, the wonderful Julie Oxenforth.